that in this episode of Luke chapter 13, we enter into the miracle of a woman who had been bent over for 18 years. She has a debilitating condition that has limited her ability to move properly. She has a condition that has limited her posture and her ability to walk up in rightward mobility. All she sees is that which is beneath her, and it is difficult for her to raise up her head. And I'm just crazy enough to believe that there may be somebody who came in here tonight who understands what this woman felt like, because you've been bent over by life for over 18 years. Maybe it ain't 18 years. Maybe it's just been 6 weeks, 6 months. Maybe it's been 6 days. But you know what it feels like to be bent over by life. I'm talking about when life has beaten you beyond belief and you've been bent over by guilt and hurt and shame and defeat and untalked about issues and unhealthy emotion and generational curses and family dysfunction. You've been bent over by grief and you've been bent over by depression. You know what it feels like to be bent over by a broken heart, bent over by a broken mind, bent over by a broken system, been bent over by a broken government, bent over by a broken economy. You know what it feels like to be bent over by church hurt. You've been bent over by your best friend, because you know what it feels like to be bent over. Well, this woman was bent over, and guess what, y'all? She's been yearning for a new perspective, and I'm just crazy enough to believe that you're here tonight because you desire to have a new perspective. But can I help you to understand there is good news tonight? There is a message from the text that helps us to understand what it feels like when God will come through because you showed up. Understand now that it is the Sabbath day in the synagogue. While there are some who are there to be cured, there were others who were there out of curiosity. Then there were some who just want to know who Christ is. And the Bible tells us that for 18 years, this woman was bent over and she could not straighten up at all. Can I tell you that theologians would suggest to us that she has an evil spirit that has been given to her of divine permission? Somebody's going to catch that in a little while. Can I help you to understand that what this woman is going through, it is suggested to us that what she is dealing with is an evil presence that was given to her of divine permission. I'm gonna help you get it. What she is dealing with is an evil problem that was given to her of divine permission, which indicates to us that there is no situation that can happen to this woman that was not first given permission by the hand of God. That heart had blessed about 30 of y'all in here, because the truth of the matter is that what you're going through right now may seem like an evil problem, but can I tell you that it's only there of divine permission? And here's the good news about divine permission, that if God has the power to call your problems into existence, he also has the power to call your problems into an expiration. Would you do me a favor? Grab somebody by the hand and tell them, neighbor, if God allowed it in my life, he can also call it to a close. So get thee behind me, Satan. You won't try to convince me that this is all there'll ever be, because God is in control of my issue. And as long as I'm going through it, God, I know that everything is going to be all right. Would you slap five with somebody and tell them, neighbor, I know that everything is going to be all right, because God is in control of my problems. My situation got to be.